my dear bloggophiles. Well, today I'm going to speak about cement mixer trucks. I was thinking about such trucks a little while ago when I was looking over a sketch I did of a truck. It was a pencil sketch, and I have a few photographs of a very old friend of mine who sadly passed away some years ago. He was called Jerry, and I suddenly realized that I had a picture of him where it was, if I cropped it at head and shoulders, I could put him into the cab of this truck. And I thought that was a canny thing to do. I mean, I could just imagine him driving around in a great big cement mixer truck. It's the sort of thing he might have liked to have done, I feel. I have great fond memories of my friend. So I was thinking about the way I photo edited it. Of course, there's a temptation to say I photoshopped it, but that's Photoshop is a brand name, and some people feel you should avoid doing that sort of thing and use a neutral term, even though these are new words in our vocabulary, relatively new at least. And photo edit is the correct way of doing it, the PC way perhaps. And it's similar to saying I vacuumed the carpet today, as opposed to saying I hoovered the carpet, because of course Hoover is a brand name. And a vacuum cleaner manufacturer such as Dyson in England would be very upset if you started talking about hoovering a carpet, because you're not doing that really, you're vacuuming it. And especially if you're using a Dyson vacuum cleaner, then you would be doing that. So there's a little thing about having to be careful about the new words that you choose to use. I often wondered why the cement in those drums, those rotating drums on the trucks, why it doesn't dry up after a whole day out, especially in the hot sun, for example. But of course it wouldn't see the sun if it was inside the cement mixer drum, I get that. And presumably they maybe have a little sprinkler system arranged in the drum so that it's kept moist. I really don't understand or know the technical details of that. I just wonder about it. I was on a trip to Los Angeles about a year ago, and I was staying with my daughter actually, and I had a walk down a sort of gently inclining slope, as it were, towards Santa Monica Boulevard, which is a very, very long boulevard which runs right down to the coast in Santa Monica. And I was walking down there one day, and I suddenly realized that I was walking past this big development where they'd either flattened some ground or they were using some space that hadn't been in built on. I don't know, I expect they've, you know, something. It was about the size of, you would think they were putting up a supermarket, a small supermarket perhaps, or something like that. Size of a couple of football pitches, I would say. And the stage they got to, as I started, you know, on my regular walks, was they got these steel rods in place. Which would be the reinforcers for a reinforced concrete base to whatever it was they were going to build, a block of flats or who knows what. And there were some fairly tall piles had been driven in as well, you know. Anyway, I usually take an interest in this sort of thing as I walk around. And a few days later, I suddenly noticed that there was a fleet of concrete mixer trucks pulled up alongside a big machine. That wasn't on a truck, I don't think. I mean, it was sort of on the side of this development, and the concrete was being taken out of the trucks, the mixer trucks, fed into this machine, and then it was piped in enormously long, flexible pipes all over the flooring of the ground floor of this building, or what was about to become a building. It was absolutely incredible. The pipes that were taking this concrete across were hoisted up way and really high in the air on these huge cranes, and the crane would move round, sort of taking the pipe with it, as it were, right across to the other side of this development. And then down on the ground there were some workmen getting hold of the outlet pipe, you know, and pointing it to where they needed the concrete to go. I was absolutely amazed, but I'd never seen anything like this before. So there was a foreman guy who looked a very efficient man, actually. He'd got a clipboard and everything, and you know. And I paused on my walk and explained to him that I was visiting from England and I'd never seen anything like that. And he told me that actually their company, building company, this machine the equipment he was using there was not the largest they'd got. He said it was a sort of medium-sized rig. I think he used the term rig, and told me that he had one much, much bigger than that. And my eyes widened and it boggled my mind. So that was quite interesting, seeing all those cement mixer trucks pulling up. I do remember having some trucks when I was a kid to play with as a dinky toy, but I don't think I had a cement mixer. I had a red London bus, which I was very fond of, and one or two other trucks. I've since been given a very nice heavy lifting crane, a yellow crane, where the actual crane bit does come up. You can pull the crane up and it has a hook dangling off the end of it as if it was a real crane, you know. I very much like that. And actually going off topic a bit, away from cement mixer trucks in this vlog, going off topic for a moment, my favourite dinky toy was I think it was an Aston Martin racing car, or it might have been another. I can't remember the brand name that went with this toy racing car, but it was fantastic. It was red, I know, and me and my friends used to, if we could find dead flat ground, preferably concrete ground, stone ground. Wood was a problem because if the flooring was tongue and grooved, where the boards met, there was often a slight dip, and that was enough to make a toy racing car, go head over heels. You know, that wasn't any good. And we used to put plasticine on the bottom of the car to give it that a bit more weight, so it got better traction on the wheels. I didn't know that was a traction, and that sort of thing was out of my childhood vocabulary at the time I was playing with it. But we did that and had a lot of fun with it. Yes. So anyway, there's I don't know how I got on to toy racing. Oh, dinky toy racing cars. Yes, I was thinking about if there was a dinky toy cement mixer, but I don't think there was when I was growing up. Okay, well, I think that's enough for cement mixers. So I will say goodbye now, and I'll talk to you later, my dear vlogophile.